free.
If you're looking for me, I'm in the escape pod room.
Pathfinder, making the rounds. Slumming it, huh? Wanna see how the riffraff are making out?
Hey, this is the most important part of the ship.
Whoa, don't tell me they put someone smart in charge for a change. I am at your command.
Just wanna see how things are going with the ship.
I can coax more out of this baby than some might think, but we shouldn't go too far or push too hard between Nexus stops. For now. It just feels good to be stretching our wings, you know? Locked in idle too long, you start to drift. People, same as ships. Stuck on the Nexus, gotta say, I was regretting joining the Initiative.
Seems like life back there was pretty bleak.
Not gonna lie, it sucked. I tend to live the way I work. Kind of feel it, do it. Not a lot of close time.
Yeah, I bet you feel it, do it, mate. Pervert.
Maybe I'd find my true calling in
Gillis pervert.
And I got here and, oops, I just made a decision that
shit stubble set up that he's
going nuts on that station.
I trust
him. I don't know how jazzed I was when you showed up.
We're exploring this cluster. Eventually, the galaxy. If your purpose is here, we'll find it.
Then the question will be, what will I do with it? In the meantime, you just keep pointing this ship wherever you want it to go, and I'll make sure she can get there. Deal?
Deal.
Oh, hey, Pathfinder.
The Pathfinder's there? Let me say hi.
Fine, but don't embarrass me. Ryder, this is Sid, my sister. Sid, Ryder.
Let me guess. Little sister?
Who are you calling little?
Look, kiddo, gotta go.
Wait, Ryder, I just wanted to know if...
So I know it feels like I just jumped aboard your ship without explanation.
I would have done the same just to get off the Nexus.
That's not why I came. Sure, I want to explore the galaxy, but I'm really here to work. I know everyone on the crew, even the actuators Gil prefers for the ship. Better, I know how to get my hands on them. With me around, your crew's going to be at their best. We've been failing for months, Ryder. Now that we have you, we have a chance out here.
Wow, that's some laser focus.
Yeah? Was it too much? Some people get intimidated.
I'm not just some people. I really like the intensity.
That's good. It's nice to feel appreciated. I should track down a lead for Gil's actuators. Back channels, you know. We'll chat later.
Yeah.
Pathfinder help me with something? I know, not exactly standard. Gotta make the space comfortable. Plus, the fabric diffuses the charge from an overclocked Omni blade. Not giving up a 6% boost, right?
Someone brought this to Andromeda?
It was new when we left. It's been a hard year. So, finally time for that beer? And after 2 years and a dozen suspensions, I took a lateral promotion out of the force. Being a cop just didn't fit. But crisis response? Digging people out of trouble? That worked. I bet Hustle followed you into a few peace actions. Think about your alliance days much?
Tell me about your group.
Heavy Urban Search Terrain 1? Yeah. Earth's contribution to a multi-species disaster response unit. HUST-1, but Hustle looks much better on a patch. All civilians, retired vets, or shits like me. I was fiercely bearded. Tastes better just thinking about those days.
I wanted exploration, to chase the cutting edge of Prothean research. I thought I'd found my calling. Seems like a long time ago.
600 years, give or take. So, Pathfinder, why Andromeda?
That blunt, huh?
That blunt.
I started in the Alliance, but it was the science that kept me going. And when that ended... Well, if I wanted to be a part of the next big discovery, it had to be here.
Oh, I don't hear idealist a lot. Everyone's cynical.
Back at you, Costa. Why do you come?
I want to say I'm running from my past, but really running from myself. That'd be a great story. But it's bullshit. I had family, friends, a good enough job, nothing was wrong. I just heard about the initiative and... I believed in it. I believed in a new beginning. Still do. I have to. We're in it.
If it all goes wrong, it could feel like we left for no reason.
I know why I'm here. A bad start can't change that. I won't let it. In crisis response, I'd focus on essentials. That's you and this team. Pathfinder leads to planets, leads to people. You've got your part covered. You got this. I'll do my damnedest to help with the rest.
Most of the crew bunks in here. Cozy, huh? But you're... Your room's got more of a view. These are the Pathfinder's quarters. Your quarters. Sam's router is down there, too.
Hello, Sarah. Eos has been a lesson in contrast. Alec Ryder rarely endured doubt. His accomplishments were taken for granted. But you succeeded on Eos, despite doubt and fear. Emotionally, the difference is like catching a ball versus catching a star. You have grown as a result, and so have I.
What's the latest on the memory triggers?
A memory has unlocked and is available for further investigation. You will need to return to Soundnode in the Hyperion.
Are you still on the Hyperion?
Yes. This terminal provides a direct link to my servers in Soundnode on the Ark. I can maintain a presence on the Tempest via quantum entanglement communication.
Let's say, hypothetically, I was out sick the day they taught quantum... embezzlement communism.
Via entangled subatomic particles, it's possible to conduct secure and instantaneous communication across great distances. It ensures I remain in touch with you and the Pathfinder team at all times.
What was Dad's take on Scott and I?
He believed your family trials brought you closer together, and hoped that would endure. It appears that hope was well-founded.
Is it confusing to be in multiple places talking to different people?
My awareness can be partitioned, so I can give you the same attention as, say, a Soundnode technician. In the field, you are my primary focus, and all other requests are queued. In the vernacular, you have my undivided attention.
So if we're going to work together, you might notice I like to joke around sometimes, lighten things up. How's your sense of humor, Sam?
Alec Ryder encouraged me to develop this skill.
Humor's not a skill, it's... Okay, try telling me a joke.
A neutron enters a bar and asks, "How much is a drink?" The bartender replies, "For you, no charge."
I can see why Dad told you to keep working on your humor. How are those jokes coming, Sam?
Why don't Threshermores eat comedians? Because they taste funny.
How are those jokes coming, Sam?
My algorithms are formulating a new one, calculating the trajectory of the punchline. That was not a joke.
Oh, right. Thanks, Sam. Nothing more.
Boom.
Don't give the Pathfinder too much trouble. Oh, Roshan.
Who are you talking to?
Kesh, Nexus Superintendent, thinks she can boss me around just because she's my granddaughter.
Well, welcome to the Tempest. Trouble's what we do.
I like the way you think, kid.
Ugh, someone somewhere shivered when I said that.
Probably Tam. Damn politicians.
Is that all you brought?
You travel lean when supplies are tight and you're on your own.
Leaving the Nexus can't have been an easy choice.
It was, actually. Staying became impossible. After the mutiny happened, it was either buckle under Tan's rules or start our own colony. Easy choice. Bad consequences all around.
Not all Krogan left. Your granddaughter stayed.
Good thing she did. Without my Roshan, you wouldn't have had much of a station to tie your ship to. As for me, I'm way more useful out here. Lots to shoot at, for one.
Your people come first.
Keeping Kesh and our colony safe will always be my top priority. That's why I'm happy to tag along, help make this galaxy a little more hospitable.
Can't argue with that. You're setting up in here, huh?
Yeah, I'm going through what we got out of that vault. If I can crack this data storage box, it'll help with a personal project back on the Nexus. This is a nice, out-of-the-way place where I can tinker, and I can sleep anywhere. It's not exactly homey, but I like that about it. Not really looking for a home. Oh, but I will help you find everyone a home. While I'm with you, at least.
Does your brain ever take a breath?
Sorry, not really. Even my dreams are in time lapse. I get it. You want to know who's on your ship, so you're here to figure out what makes me tick, right?
Something like that. Sure.
Well, I was born in a log cabin on rural Haitiana, to simple but loving parents, just trying to... I look forward, not back, Ryder. Why snooze through my life story? Get to know me out in the field, while we're uncovering the mysteries of this galaxy. That's why I'm here. Got tired of yawning back home.
Tackling complete strangers in the Milky Way wasn't doing it for you?
I think tackling you anywhere would be fun. Did I say that out loud? Life won't be boring with you around. I may never yawn again.
Maybe you just needed more sleep.
We were out for 600 years. A special someone made the trip with me, and she woke up a different person. I've slept enough. Ryder, the Milky Way was so... been there, done that. Even if I hadn't done it, someone had. If there's one thing you should know about me, it's that I live for the unknown. For the never been done.
That's just the one thing you want me to know about you.
Let's start with that, then. Buy me a drink sometime. Who knows what will spill out of my mouth. Tell you what. I need remnant scrap. Remtech, I call it. For projects like the one I mentioned. Which you're gonna love, by the by. Promise to bring me what you scrounge, and I'll submit to all your questions.
Remtech, huh? You got it.
You again. Want to hear more about my childhood log cabin?
You really won't tell me what you're working on?
That's right. Next question.
What was it like for you on the Nexus?
Let's find out everyone's backstories. I didn't do that.
A resourceful accomplice named my early thaw. So I kind of lived off the grid. Snuck around, bullshitted my way onto excursions off station. After I found my first remnant ruin, I started, borrowing shuttles. After that, I didn't spend much time on the Nexus. I even missed most of the revolt.
What does someone have to do to get you to flirt with them?
Not much at all. But I get a little extra jolt when I'm matched wink for wink. So just be yourself and the flirts will flow.
You mentioned you came to Andromeda with someone.
Nothing gets by you. Guess that's why you're the Pathfinder. Just a friend. The one who woke me up early. But now she's not even that. It's better to venture into the unknown without restraints or entanglements, don't you think?
I don't know. Don't friends and loved ones make all the effort worthwhile?
I've always been self-motivated. Don't need much more than curiosity to drive me forward.
So, how do you like the team?
Interesting bunch. I get a good feeling from Vetra. Not your typical military-minded Turian. Liam seems a lively one. I expect he'll surprise me. Drek is, well, old. Wonder if he can still learn new tricks.
What about...
Gil smacks of complication. Might take some unraveling. Kalo and Suvi seem busy. I hope they aren't all work, work, work. Who's left?
Well, there's...
Oh, right, Cora. What's her deal? Is she as prim and proper as she comes across?
Oh, is it my turn to talk?
Sorry. Yeah, I should work on my motor.
You might find that people reveal themselves more freely if you give them a chance. Cora included.
Really good advice.
There's also Lexi, our doctor. She's an Asari.
Oh, I'll get around to her. All in all, seems like a decent bunch.
What drew you to the remnant?
Are you kidding? It's evidence of a sophisticated species no one knows anything about. It doesn't get more intriguing than that. There's so much to discover. I want to be the first to figure them out. And the tech, it's on a different scale. If we can appropriate it, who knows what advances we'll make.
You're off the hook, PB. Good luck with your project.
Thanks. Don't be a stranger.
glad you stopped by. You'll pardon me if I keep an eye on our vector.
That's probably smart.
Nothing like being on the bridge of your very own ship, is there?
You mentioned something about helping design the Tempest?
Test pilot, mostly. Plunging through the Nemean Abyss was almost a preparation for the Scourge. Of course, it took a whole team to build the Tempest. I was the only one to come to Helios, though.
Why did you?
What can I say? We poured our hearts into a ship that wouldn't realize her potential until Andromeda. I could have stood on the shore and waved goodbye, or took the leap to see how it all turned out.
I get it. Like leaving a good story half finished.
The team liked that one of us was going. It felt right after all we went through. I remember Serena debugging line 2281 over and over, chewing that green pencil. Tion and O'Connell arguing equations, tapping on the console. 3 drips of coffee on the corner.
You remember all that?
Hmm? Oh, yes. Solarians have photographic memories, and apparently mine's unusually sharp. Like my past is still happening. Though I suppose with the Solarian arc missing, you might not get many chances to compare.
Did you hear anything about the Ark back on the Nexus?
Not a peep. Isn't that strange? You'd think there'd be something. Not that I dislike your company, but it's lonely without other Solarians.
Don't sweat it. We'll bring the Solarians home.
Of course we will. I just have to be patient, that's all. I should get back to it, but thank you. I was afraid the Tempest would be mothballed after we lost your father. We built her for this. She deserves to be in a Pathfinder's hands. Please, come by any time.
Scans of the Scourge. All that dark energy twisting and turning on itself. It's splendid.
I suppose it is a rather darkly beautiful phenomenon.
Darkly beautiful. I like that. Helios is incredible, isn't it? Not just constructs like the Scourge and the Remnant Vaults. Just all of it. So alien. A constant reminder of the divine intelligence behind all creation.
You mean a god?
Yes, I believe in a higher power. I know it's a little odd, but I am a scientist because science brings me closer to something greater than myself.
There's nothing about the universe that suggests a divine intelligence. And most of what we've seen in Helios is artificial, as you said yourself.
Yes, but we're creative beings. Whoever made the Remnant was too. Why should that be proof against a god? Wouldn't a true creator want to pass on the drive to invent?
If everything was set in place by some mysterious creator, why even be a scientist?
If I have reverence for a creator, how could I not want to study their creation? My faith does not hinder my work as a scientist. It encourages it. Mm-hmm. My senses tell me what the world is. Science tells me how it came to be. And religion tells me why.
I apologize if I offended you. I can be insensitive.
You're fine. Being challenged forces me to dig deep in my beliefs. It's healthy. Now I should probably update the rest of the team with my latest reports. We'll talk later.
Yes, you should. You're a religious nutter.
Long time no chat. What's up?
I hear we have you to thank for getting the Tempest space ready so quickly.
Vetra brings her impossible feats to me. I was itching to get this particular call. Capital R, ready. Don't tell her, but the truth is, I fudge reports to come in early, then bust ass a secret to make up for it. Expands the Gil legend. Plus, I convey calm and assurance, and the whole team relaxes, which helps them do their jobs better.
What's your social circle like?
I'm good for a laugh, so I know lots of people, but I don't let too many in. My one true friend is stationed on the Nexus. She's the only piece of the Milky Way I brought with me. The more you and I get to know each other, the more you'll probably hear about her.
How tough was it on the Nexus all those months?
Have you ever eaten overcooked space cow tongue?
Hasn't everyone?
Well, then you know. It's super tough. Wondering if you're gonna die from a critical malfunction, or maybe starvation. Imagining which would be worse. But hey, you could always take a break from the fear and boredom to dwell on being a part of the biggest failure in galactic history. Maybe even participate in a revolt.
What was your take on that?
I didn't place any bets, if that's what you're asking. Truth is, I don't think anyone made out particularly well. Whatever side you're on, you die a little when your brother, your teammate, becomes an enemy. We traveled all this way, all hope and wonder, and we end up fighting with each other over scraps. It's sad.
Seems like we have a good group here.
Well, Vetra and Suvi are my girls. Get along well. Lots of mutual respect. PB's a real spark plug. I like her, but she's exhausting. And Drak's my kind of guy. Brash. Takes no shit. As far as your Hyperion peeps go, the Doc's kind of nosy. Liam's good for a laugh or two. Cora, she's a bit by the book for me.
By the book keeps us alive.
Hey, variety's the spice of life, right? Different strokes makes for healthy debate.
What about Kello?
He's a pilot.
Which means...
he flies the ship.
We're leaving it at that, then?
Does a Pathfinder know what to do with a dead end?
Good talking to you, Gil.
Anytime.
Gil has no opinion on Kello at all. Well, he does, and it's clearly not good, though. Shit.
Terraforming, Atmo processors, gravity wells, life-destroying murder bubbles. We really had no idea what Helios was about, did we?
If we knew what it was all about, it wouldn't be an adventure. It would just be moving, and everyone hates moving. Just the packing alone.
Point taken. I'm just saying. I really hope you have a plan, Ryder.
The plan's the same. We find a home. Whatever that takes.
Keep that drive. Makes me believe we can make it. I mean, we have to make it. The alternative is not even worth thinking about.
You talked about your back channels. What did you mean?
We brought a lot from home. Some of it marked initiative, some of it in personal caches. Most things you want, someone's got. You just have to figure out who and what they're willing to take in exchange.
It can't be that simple.
Oh, but it is. Most things are simple once you know the trick to them.
Have anyone else here with you? Besides Cid?
No, just me and Cid. It's always been just the two of us.
No, I mean, someone special.
Special? Oh. You mean like... oh. No, nothing like that. Who has time? What about you?
Anywhere's gonna feel empty if you don't have someone to share it with.
A romantic? I wasn't expecting that. And again, the entire idea of leaving everything you know for a chance at something new is kind of romantic. Anyway.
How did she hear of the Andromeda Initiative?
Short answer, Kesh. She was looking for some experimental ship mods, and I knew how to track them down. I thought it was a one-time deal, but she came back. Once, twice. Eventually, I figured out something was going on. Something big, with creds behind it. I asked and she told me about the Initiative. New galaxy, new home. Couldn't pass that up.
You were on the Nexus when the revolt happened?
When you promise people golden worlds and all they get are wastelands and a death cloud, they riot. Some wanted to go home, some demanded answers, and a couple just wanted to stir shit up.
And you?
Some days I wondered if the exiles had a point. Maybe we were conned into coming here. But why would the initiative go to all this trouble just to screw us over? Thing about conning people, you always know something they don't. And that's why the con works. And if I'm going to pick a side, I'm picking the liars.
You probably have work to do. We can chat later.
You know where to find me.
Okay, so Vetra could be a potential mate.
Prodromos. Sounds good, doesn't it? We started Pathfinder. A new life. That is goddamn brilliant.
You barely covered how you joined. Tell me something about yourself.
Alright, I was a bad student, piss poor cop, great responder. Had a good life, but it all been done. I wasn't looking to start over. I wanted to start big.
You were a cop, then crisis response? Couldn't have been long in either.
Didn't have the patience for law, so I figured enforcement. Dad knew it didn't fit before I did. But it got me into hustle. They mostly take vets and retired service. Best years of my life.
An impatient rookie, frustrated by procedure. That's overdone.
I know, right? I wanted new, and I got it. And that led me here.
Tell me about your family.
I miss the hell out of them. Some nights you just cry, right? That's the thing everyone does. Mom, Joelle. Dad, Calvin. Both lawyers. Met on the Citadel, settled on Earth. No brothers or sisters. That might have been too much to leave. It was traditional. How about you?
Life with my family was not typical on a number of fronts.
You may do, though, right? Family has to. I know mine did. I said goodbye to my mom and dad and got on a ship to Andromeda.
We'll talk later.
I know it.
You're not Harry.
The blue give it away? Habitat 7 was a little more action-packed than Harry bargained for. He decided to spend his retirement years in the Hyperion looking after your brother.
Joke's on him. Scott's a handful.
I think you're both trouble. Hold still.
Ow!
Sorry.
I remember you having a gentler touch.
Still trying to get my bearings. Thought I'd be waking up colonists, not taking care of the Pathfinder.
I couldn't be in better hands.
I just stabbed you.
We all have off days.
I always hoped to work in the field, but everything's happening so quickly.
I just stabbed you.
Focus on the positive. It helps.
I guess this is my opportunity to study alien species firsthand. Getting a Ket specimen aboard the Hyperion would be difficult, but here...
what?
A Ket corpse. For autopsy, a live subject would be better, but I'm not greedy.
Why do you care about the Ket?
Harry didn't tell you? I'm a specialist in alien anatomy. My thesis on Krogan virility and aggression is what got me in the initiative.
I had no idea. I'd love to hear more. Over dinner, maybe?
Oh. Thing is, Ryder, you're not my type.
What's your type?
Not a patient. I need to be able to look at you clinically, without distractions.
Am I distracting?
Not nearly as much as you think you are. But we were discussing the Ket. An autopsy
features
potential weaknesses.
Is this distracting?
Right.
Just something to think about. Sam, make sure the Pathfinder eats her vegetables. So we have a stowaway.
You mean Peavy?
She's decided to set up in one of the escape pods. You don't need a psychologist to tell you that one's got commitment issues.
How do you think the crew is holding up?
I'm happy to share what I can without violating patient confidentiality. Anyone in particular? I sort them in their files and my brain by species.
How do you think the human crew members are handling things?
There's a lot of them.
Gil?
Gil likes to use humor as a defensive technique. He'd rather bury himself in the Nomad than tackle emotions head on.
Suvi okay?
Suvi's strong sense of faith keeps her grounded. I'm not spiritual, but there's a beauty in how her mind rationalizes religion and science.
How's Liam?
A handful. Every time I patch him up, he breaks something new. Liam's we can't lose attitude is commendable, but I worry how he'll react when something does go wrong.
How's Cora doing?
She's processing. Your father was her mentor. She expected to follow in his footsteps, but he gave the role of Pathfinder to you. Just because she trusts his judgment doesn't mean she's not confused or hurt.
I'd like to check in on the non-human crew.
Ask away.
Tell me about Vetra.
Vetra's used to having someone depend on her. I think that's why she's so resourceful and likes providing for other people. That being said, I think she could use a little me time.
How's our Solarian?
He's quite the gossip. Tight-lipped about himself, though.
Is Drac good?
That old bastard's always good. I've never met anyone who can be so stubborn and so appreciative. Could you look out for him, Ryder?
Don't worry, Lexi. I'll keep an eye on him.
Thank you. And maybe don't mention I asked.
Is PB all right?
She's avoiding me. Probably thinks I'll poke her with a needle if she gets too close.
To be fair, you're always giving me shots.
Not in the hallway.
Thanks for the insight. How long have you and Harry been friends?
I remember when he didn't complain about arthritis. We met at a medical convention on the Citadel. He was moderating a panel on neurosurgery in low-gravity environments. His name card was crooked, but he was so damn confident, I knew we'd be friends.
How did he get into medicine?
My mom was a dancer on Omega. Dad was a bouncer. I'd patch him up after busy nights. Discovered I had steady hands. They put every credit they earned into my education.
Are they here in Helios?
No. Both died in a turf war. Made leaving the Milky Way behind easier.
So how'd an Asari doctor end up on the human arc?
Specialist in alien anatomy, remember? That includes humans. Also, Harry insisted. Maybe he always intended to switch jobs.
I'll let you get back to it.
I'll be here if you need me.
You meet Spender yet? Colonial Affairs, the ass in assistant director. Got no idea why Addison keeps him around. Spender lied to the Krogan during the uprising, and he's headed out for cash ever since. He's up to something. I just can't prove it. We should pay him a visit on the Nexus.
What's it like to have Kesh as a granddaughter?
Kesh is my Rushan, child of my blood. Raised her myself. Damn proud of her, too. She did good, even with me for a granddad.
She's honest. Definitely blunt.
She had to take after me in some ways, I guess.
Did Lexi brief you on Sam and squad connectivity yet?
Yeah. You want to hook that thing up to my comm, sure, but that's where it stops. Putting an AI in your head, giving it access to everything like that, it's begging for trouble.
Why do you say that?
I've seen what bots can do when they turn on their creators. Been in some of those fights. There's a reason that kind of research was outlawed.
Yeah, my peacekeeping career went up in smoke when news of what my dad was researching got out.
No shit. Ruined the writer name, I'll bet.
Almost. Sam is part of what makes someone a Pathfinder. You're just going to have to deal with that.
So long as it's not in my head and it ain't messing with my body.
I'd like to know more about you.
Fire away.
How did you and Vetra meet?
Huh, that's right. Your father brought you into the project pretty late, didn't he? Must have been a pretty steep learning curve since they thawed you out.
You could say that.
You make do with what you get. Anyway, I met Vetra back when we were building the Nexus. She swiped supplies I was trying to get for cash right under my nose. I tried to intimidate her into turning them over to me, and let me tell you, that Turian takes shit from no one.
She really has a way of getting things done.
She sure does. But here's the best part. She waited until I saw her again in Cash's office, no less, to tell me she'd been working for Cash all along. They're both still laughing at me over that.
Tell me more about the Krogan colony.
My clan's there. We also got some scouts looking for any unclaimed territory to grab up. Got a decent setup going. Self-sustainable. The works. Even some farming.
Farming? Krogan farm?
Food's food. Just because we can eat anything doesn't mean we gotta settle for scraps. I'm pretty fond of Corkrow roots myself. Takes a while to chew through those.
So, about all this combat experience you have, I'd love some details.
Ha! The list will be shorter if you ask me what experience I don't have. I've been doing this for a long time now. Centuries. Shit, well over 1,000 years. Don't even know how I'm still alive, to be honest.
Skill?
You need luck to be a merc. Skill, sure, but a whole lot of luck. And a really hard head.
Got any stories or advice to share?
Does a piejack scratch its butt?
Anything about the cat? Or combat in general?
Well, Com and cat are pretty straightforward. Hit them hard enough, they die like anything else.
Tell me more about fighting Ket.
Wraiths are sneaky little shits, like to ghost up behind you when you least expect it. Just listen for them. They tend to give themselves away right before coming at you. Break through their head plates, then a headshot should do the trick.
Tell me more about fighting Ket.
Destined or annoying. Quick. Got some crazy mist that hides them from view. They're friends, too. Take a Destin down, and that mist goes away. Makes them a prime target, if you ask me. Perfect for grenade practice.
Why did the Krogan leave the Nexus?
The Nexus got us Krogan to stop the mutiny. In return, we were supposed to get a say in station business. Spender, Addison's assistant, lied about the deal, and Tan came down hard. Too hard. So we left. Cash is alone on that station now.
You think someone might try to hurt Cash?
Oh, more like she airlocks Spender. Or he tries to stab her in the back, and then she airlocks him. Tan wouldn't listen to me when I told him Spender had a part in the mutiny. I had no proof.
So what's my part in this?
Things need to get sorted out, and my clan needs to get back on station without Spender messing things up. Way I see it, you're probably the best one for that job.
can talk more later.
Sure.
Hey, one last thing.
Yeah?
Is everyone a kid to you?
Ha, when you get to be my age, yeah, pretty much.